Hello, and welcome to the first OpenMW-CS exclusive video on our channel. This video covers what's new in version 0.37.0 of the editor. To see what's new in 0.37.0 of the OpenMW engine, please check out the corresponding release video. For those of you still here, you must be eager to hear something about the editor's progress, so make yourself comfortable and prepare your eyes for white space. A whole lot of white space. The goal of OpenMW-CS is to provide a powerful editor to create mods or even entire new games using the OpenMW engine. Our homebrew editor will eventually allow Morrowind modders to do everything that they could with the original construction set, and even more, while being both easy to use and highly customizable. Unfortunately, the editor's development has always lagged somewhat behind the game engine. It had fewer shiny features to present, and no real immediate usefulness due to missing content and features. Thankfully, since at least version 0.36.0, this has changed. OpenMW-CS is already suitable for creating smaller mods, and except its incomplete 3D rendering component, almost all content is accessible. In terms of new features, OpenMW version 0.37.0 was more an editor-related release. So let's have a look at what's new. When you create a mod, you often have to enter IDs. For example, to attach a script to an NPC, or to add an NPC to one of Morrowind's factions. In OpenMW-CS, it is possible to drag and drop records in order to add them to an entry. However, you may want to insert an ID manually in certain situations. In this case, the new ID autocomplete feature takes effect and lists every ID in question in a drop-down list. This should greatly improve your working speed and prevent common typos. Moreover, non-editable fields in record subviews are now selectable. For example, this allows modders to copy record IDs to the clipboard. With our current release, it is finally possible to sort search results and entries in the verifier report view. In addition, info tables which contain groups of associated records can now be sorted globally while retaining the correct order within the groups. You will also notice that the default sorting order has been set to ascending order. Record IDs starting with the letter Z will now return to their shadowy depth. OpenMW version 0.37.0 further improves the usability of our script editor. Undo and redo shortcuts now work inside the script editor, meaning you can correct your newly created infinite loop with a single hand movement. If that weren't enough, clicking on a search result that is referencing a script now takes the user to the appropriate line of that script. The current release also adds buttons for deleting, cloning, and reverting a script, as well as next script and previous script buttons. Additionally, a real-time error check has been implemented, which also catches changes made in other scripts. Editing records could become really tedious in the past, especially when you wanted to modify a specific record in another table, for example the race record of an NPC. In version 0.37.0, the context menu shows the option to directly switch to the selected entry. Formerly, color picking in OpenMW-CS was limited to entering hexadecimal RGB values or the corresponding color names. The new version brings a freshly baked color picker. Hopefully, you can still decide on a color in the future. When you have dealt with a record, you may want to close it. In order to do this, you can now use the shortcut Ctrl+Shift+W. Please note that this only works if the target subview has the input focus. In addition, the removal of an edit record now properly closes the corresponding subview. Deleting a base record, as always, disables the appropriate subview window. Version 0.37.0 also introduces the possibility to clone deleted records. Allow me to call your attention to the fact that base records, which are determined by subordinated data files, cannot be removed from the subordinated file, but rather change their status to deleted. Only those records can be cloned after deletion. Adding or cloning records now accurately updates the table filters in order to refresh the list of filtered records. The same goes for the removal of records. In the past, there have been some problems with undo and redo commands. Undoing changes on a record would not correctly reset the modified status to base or edit. That was true for both common data entries as well as nested data entries. Moreover, the undo and redo labels in the menu bar formally stated incorrect information. All these issues have been fixed in the current release. Version 0.37.0 simplifies cell loading in the scene view by rendering arrows at cell borders, which load the corresponding adjacent cell on a click. Also, mouse picking in the scene view has been implemented. That means OpenMW-CS is finally able to detect mouse clicks in the scene and sends all information about this event to the corresponding handler. The mouse cursor's position, what button was pressed, and the relevant entities under the cursor. We are currently missing the handling tasks, though. For now, you will only be able to select instances, but editing the actual scene should soon be possible. This, combined with the upcoming drag and drop feature, means scene editing is approaching basic usability. OpenMW version 0.37.0 extends the available contents of our construction set. For example, it is now possible to add meta information to your data files. Moreover, several missing data fields and tables have been added, including the info conditions subtable and topic info records, the race attributes and skill bonus subtables and race records. Various NPC data entries, like an NPC's rank, their default disposition, the NPC's skills and attributes, or the gold stock. The trading gold amount for creature records. And, last but not least, various cell data entries like light settings, the cell is interior flag, or the sleep is illegal flag. Version 0.37.0 also adds record verifiers to several tables to check the integrity of all records included, namely the magic effects table, the sound generators table, and the path grid table. Furthermore, the verify report now is refreshable and shows the severity of detected issues. OpenMW-CS now provides a merge tool which is capable of merging .omw add-on files into their base .omw game file, creating a new .omw game file in the process. If those file types don't mean anything to you, let me elaborate on this issue. A .omw game file contains all base data of a game. In relation to vanilla Morrowind, the Morrowind.esm file matches this criterion. Please note that in OpenMW you can only activate one .omw game file at a time. Any file adding data to the base content is a .omw add-on file. The vanilla counterpart would be any .esp file, but also the bloodmoon.esm and tribunal.esm files. While the OpenMW file types currently are very similar to the original ones, we will extend them after version 1.0 has been released. Wow, that was a lot of changes. If you're interested in joining this project, just take the chance. OpenMW-CS is in need of more manpower to catch up with the engine's development status. So if you have some Qt basics or want to develop mods for OpenMW in the not-too-distant future, just drop by and help Zini and his guys to create a tool to banish Bethesda's cumbersome construction set. Of course, we are also grateful for anyone not only testing the actual game engine, but keeping an eye on the editor as well. Just grab this fine piece of software which is included in every OpenMW release and simply start doing things. I bet you'll run into a bug here and there. In case you haven't watched the engine video for this release, you better hurry over there. Unless you want to miss the announcement of the new OpenMW fork for The Elder Scrolls 6, Agonia. It's your call. Also, don't forget to check out the official release notes, or rather release catalog, and visit our forums on openmw.org. See you soon for another OpenMW-CS video update. And as always, thanks for watching.